No, seriously, who is this guy even? I don't even know him.
Boss, his name is Ming Wei.
Okay, fine. I mean, just because his name also has a Ming memes, I must interview him, eh?
He has 7.9 million followers on TikTok.
Wait, what? What's up everyone, this is Xiao Ming from SGAG and today I have with me apparently Singapore's number one TikToker Ming Wei. Say hi.
Hello. Hello.
7.9 million, it's not 79,000 or 790, right? 7.9 million followers. When did you start your TikTok?
I think I started around end 2018.
End 2018 and within like what, 2 years you have 7.9 million?
It's only like recently that I started to grow a bit more.
Like recently as like what every day you grow by 100,000 kind?
Not so much, yeah.
What, and I heard that what, your dad has 2.3 million followers?
Oh yeah.
Your dad has a TikTok also? What am I doing with my life? I think I should just retire. So I mean, you have 7.9 million followers on TikTok, which is about 7,870,000 more than me. Do you mind actually giving my account a shout out so that your followers, right, will come and follow me?
I can try.
Can
yeah. Yeah.
Okay, let's do it right now. You look into the camera, right? And tell your followers to follow me because like, I'm damn funny or something like that. La.
Okay, hi. Follow Xiao Ming because we both have Ming.
Oh wow. Oh okay, yeah! That's great, that's right, that's the reason that you should follow me. I think I need a toilet break right now, so make yourselves comfortable over here, you know. I'll be back in a while, okay? Ah, oh my god, the heck? 17.8 million for this video? The heck, 32 million for this video? Okay, sorry. You know, urgent. I know you 7.9 million one, very busy. But the 28k one need to go toilet break, means need to go toilet break. You know, so I was just looking through your videos, right? And a lot
in
of
the
those...
toilet?
No. Huh? What in the toilet? No lah, of course not. I heard from somewhere lah. Okay? So a lot of your videos during the circuit breaker period were all pranks, right? So on a scale, right, of 1 to fake, how real are your pranks?
I think it's as fake as your lame jokes.
Okay, so you wanna play like that lah, huh? So 7.9 million then can play like that. It's okay, never mind. I cannot fight with numbers, I will fight with something else. So, I heard that before you became a TikTok superstar, you were actually a taekwondo like national team, like superstar training for the Tokyo 2020 Olympics.
Yep.
Like how, what was this? What is this a question? No! Let Ming Wei kick a toilet roll off your head. Guys, come on. What if he kicks my head?
You need the views.
I'm legit like super nervous right now.
I'm nervous too, actually.
Like, hoi! Let's do it! Do you need me to go a bit lower or not? Like, I don't know. Have you been training often?
Yeah.
How long have you been training for? How young did you start training taekwondo?
2007.
That's many years. Okay, I trust you. Can I see like, how high you can kick? Just need to make sure. Like that. That's just nice my face. You know?
Ready?
Yeah. I'm damn scared, guys. Okay? Are you sure? I close my eyes. Do you use your hand to strip it off? Or he really legit kicked it off my head. Oh my god, that's damn scary. Okay, Ken, my turn now. Don't make me do this, guys. This better have like 5 million views or something like that, right? Let's get selfie on TikTok, everybody. Follow me. I'm still just trying to like recover from the shock of getting a toilet roll kicked off my head. For the views, ah. For the views. I actually think, you know, you should stick to doing pranks more than taekwondo. I don't know, it scares me. But at least your pranks, you know, makes people laugh. But this just scares me, man. Anyway, I understand that you're part of the Headmill Creators Network, where you know, it's made of a huge community of creators like yourself. Zoom in. Yes! Got you!
Can you like cut that?
No. You know, you need to do real pranks. This is real pranks, man. Let the shifu teach you, alright? I've been in the scene long before you came onto TikTok, alright? So just a tip lah. No worries. I mean, if this go viral, you just credit me, okay? No worries. Anyway, as I was saying, like, you're part of the Headmill Creators Network, where it's made up of a huge community of creators like yourself, and you have been working on a number of, you know, branded campaigns. So do you think it's actually possible that you ever make content creation on TikTok your full-time job?
I think I thought of it, and actually I'm trying it now because I'm like my final year of school.
Like, which school are you in?
Oh, I'm in NTU Psychology.
Yeah, have you applied whatever you have learned in psychology in TikTok or Taekwondo?
I mean, it helps sometimes.
You play mind games with your opponent. You just scare them, right? Like what you did to.
Not really more of that, but it's more like you understand how people think and what people want.
Right. So would you say that's your formula for success?
For me, I try to make content that what people want to see. Yeah.
I also ma, but then nobody wants to see it, then how?
But the thing is, I also fail many times.
Oh wow, this is like some, let's cue the emo music. So you failed many times and then now you have found a bit of a groove. Right, you somewhat know what the audience like.
Yeah.
So what does the audience like? Sorry, I'm just taking down notes over here. Like in three points.
I think people like to see a bit like fails.
Okay. Ah, so that means just now the toilet roll is not a fail, it means...
I think it may work, but if I hit you instead, maybe it'll be different.
Okay, we do again. Start the paper. And what would you say is the other two?
The other two, I think, is to be consistent.
So consistently getting smacked in the head.
If people really follow you for something, then that means they like the thing, so you should do more of it. Then you jump around.
So don't like, just keep doing like random things.
Yeah.
Okay. And what would you say is the last one then?
I think people like to see messy.
Messy?
No, like things getting messy.
Like for example?
Like example, you know.
Your hair. So you were saying messy. Like
example, if the eggs hit you, the flour hits you.
Oh. Yeah. Okay, can you bring the flour in? Actually, we have almost come to the end of the interview, and I've got one question for you. Since you know you are a multi-talented person, I'm pretty sure you can guess this joke. Not a joke, it's a question. Do you know what did a generous donut seller say to his customer? It's got to do with what you are doing today. Or you'll give up. Give up, never mind. If you give up, then you just do another shout out to your fans to follow me again.
Follow Xiao.
Wow, by the end of this video, I will have at least two more followers. You don't know, give up. I'll give you a hint, okay? I actually printed because I kind of guessed that, you know, you might not be able to guess it, because not everybody is at my level. But it's okay, I understand that. It happens often. So I actually prepared to help my guests. So, look at this, right? This is exactly what you're just in today, right? Yeah. So what was this guy doing? What did you just do?
A cake?
Okay lah, I mean, what is the sport called?
Taekwondo.
Yeah, Taekwondo, right? And what's this?
This is a walnut or donut or almond?
Okay, yeah, simple one. This is a nut. When you piece these two together, how do you say it? This is a what sport? Hey, that's like primary school, like teaching primary school kid, eh? What's this sport?
Taekwondo.
Then say it together.
Taekwondo donut.
Taekwondo donut! Alright, thanks everyone, I think we have come to the end of the interview. No, there's no one finding it funny. It's funny, right?
Okay, yeah.
Thanks everyone! Bye!
Okay, thanks, bye!
What's up everyone? This is Xiaoming and you're watching Not Bad TV. Click here for more videos, click here to subscribe, and click on the notification bell if you want to get notified for more videos. Oh, you know why bicycle cannot stand on its own? Because it's too tired!